Hey guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. So I finally made a new video for you guys, and I am so excited to do this one because it is about doing this full-on glammed makeup with very affordable products. A lot of the products that I am using today are literally under $10, and I bought them at Walmart. So I'm basically gonna be talking to you guys about my favorites. If you guys are interested in seeing all the products that I used, stay tuned. I'm gonna be showing you guys step by step all the products that I use. The foundation I'm gonna be using today, it's gonna be from L'Oreal, and it is True Match, and it looks like this. This one is in the shade W4.5. So I'm just gonna open this up, and it doesn't have a pump, so I usually just dab it into my face like this. Don't forget to bring the foundation down to your neck. That way it just looks like an even color, okay? So then just I spread the foundation, and the brush that I am using is a Morphe G36 brush. Then I'm gonna go ahead and just go in with my damped beauty blender, and I'm gonna press my foundation in. Perfect, so now that my foundation is completely set in, I'm gonna go ahead and do contouring. I've been using this very religiously, so I really, really like it. And it is from Milani Cosmetics. It's kind of like a contour stick like this. If you open it up, it has like, I've used most of it, so it's usually a lot longer. It looks like this. And then on the other side, it has like a little cream highlight. I honestly don't use this side. I just use it for the stick. I really, really, really like it. So I'm just gonna go ahead and go in and contour in the areas that I'm gonna wanna contour, which is usually, you know, the cheekbones. Get some up in this five head. And I started recently doing this. I've learned a lot of new techniques to show you guys that I really, really like, at least for myself, you know. So everybody is different, but this is something I like. And it's just contouring right down here. And this just gives me that super defined jawline. And then I'll just kind of like that. I know it's a lot of fucking contouring, right? So then I'm just gonna go ahead and go in with my Morphe M436 brush, and I'm just gonna buffer in that contour. I must say, please don't forget, do not press down, and make sure that you blend it accordingly, like all around, so it doesn't just look like you have like a big blob right here. That shit drives me insane. Like, when I see people with that, I'm just like... Now, I use my Morphe E47 brush to contour my nose. I just, you know, swipe up and backwards, up and backwards. I'm gonna go ahead and go in with some concealer. Now what I'm gonna be using, it's gonna be again from Milani Cosmetics, and it is gonna be Conceal and Perfect. It says it's a 2-in-1 foundation and concealer. So this one, I picked it up in a lighter shade because I use it as a concealer. This is in the shade medium beige, and I am gonna just squirt some on my brush. Not a lot, just, you know, a little. And I'm gonna apply it in the areas I like to brighten. What I like to do here is I'll bring the brush and I'll just kind of like dab in some right here. And then I'll do the same to the other side, just to really define my contour. Then I'm gonna go ahead and just go back in with my damped beauty blender, and I'm gonna buffer that in. Okay, so now that I've done my foundation, highlight, and contour, I'm gonna make sure that the creases under my eye are buffered out. And then I'm gonna just use setting powder and set that in. Now the setting powder I am using is Revolution Luxury Baking Powder in banana. This whole little thing probably costed me about $7 to $10, and it lasted me a very, very long time. Now that I have put the setting powder on my face, I'm just gonna leave it on there for a bit. I'm gonna go ahead and brush on my eyebrows. So now for my eyebrow routine, I'm gonna be using this NYX Cosmetics Professional Makeup Micro Brow Pencil. And this, it just has like a little thing like this. It's like you can turn it out. And then on the other side, it has a spoolie, which mine is pretty dirty because I bitch be using it. Okay, so again, I'm just gonna go ahead and go in. I'm gonna outline the shape of my eyebrows and then kind of shade inside, just like that. And I'm gonna do that same to the top. Okay, so what I went ahead and did is I outlined it and then I just used the spoolie to blend in the brow. Just like that. So I've been using brow gels all the time. And the brow gel that I use is gonna be one that I got in my BoxyCharm. It's called the Brow Gal. I'm not sure how much it costs it, so I'm not gonna use it for the sake of my video today. I do not have any other ones. So what I'm gonna go ahead and do is just use my mascara and kind of just brush my brow. Very softly, guys, just like that. Then I'm gonna go ahead and go in with my spoolie and kind of like spread that out. Okay, so now that I have finished both of my brows, I'm gonna go ahead and go in with my eyeshadow palette. I'm gonna be using this palette right here, which is from Melissa Michelle, and she is a YouTube blogger. Hey! So I bought this one at Ulta. It's from Ulta Beauty, so it looks like she partnered with Ulta and did this palette. I'm not completely sure, to be honest, so don't quote me on that. But I've never used this before. When you open it, it looks like this. And I love that it has like a little liquid lipstick. We're actually gonna be using this lipstick. I've never used this, like I said before, so we hope that it works out. We're gonna see what we could create with this baby. Now, the shades I'm gonna be using are gonna be mainly this one, this one, this one, and maybe like a shimmery. So I'm gonna go in with the lightest shade, which is this one right here. It's called Rosemary. And I'm just gonna apply this all over my lid. Now, this palette was actually pretty affordable. When I got it, I honestly don't remember how much it costed. I believe it costed about $10 to $11. It wasn't expensive, but one thing I can say, I feel like the colors are not as pigmented as I would like. I'm gonna make this palette work, but it just, I feel like I have to be grabbing the same color and pressing it in over and over again. So then I'm gonna go ahead and go in with this warmer shade right here, which is kind of like an orangey shade, and it's called Bing Bing. And I'm gonna apply this all on my crease. So dabbing the color, always dabbing the color in will give you more intensity. So try doing that. Then I'm gonna go ahead and just go in with the little darker shade right here, which is called Harley. And I'm just gonna apply it on the outer corners. Beautiful. So then now I'm gonna go in with, see this on the corner out here? I'm gonna use it on my lid. So like right here in this area. And then now I'm just gonna dust everything off. I'm gonna go ahead and go in with setting spray, and this one is from Mario Badescu skincare, and I'm just gonna spray. This is the lavender one. I also have another one, which is the rose petals. So I'm just gonna set this. Now this alone just costed me about $6 to $7. Moving on, I'm gonna be using a highlighter. Now this is also a very, very, very good highlighter for the price. I believe I got these for like $2, $3 at Walmart, and they are from Wet n Wild. The ones that I'm gonna be using today are gonna be the Golden Flower Crown, and this is like a really light shade, and then I'm gonna be using like a rosy color, and this one is gonna be called Crown of Canopy. And again, they're super affordable and you can buy them at Walmart. That's where I purchased mine. I'm pretty sure they have it at Target as well. I'm gonna go ahead and spray my brush. Don't forget, spray your brush when you're highlighting. And then I'm gonna go ahead and go in, and this one is the lighter shade I was talking to you guys about. And I'm just gonna grab some and put some right in this area right here. Okay, so this is what it looks like. I applied some on my cheekbones, my nose bridge, the tip of my nose, my marupisita, and then I also applied some on my chin and very lightly on my forehead. Like, I put it on my cheekbones and then I bring it around and I kind of just stop right here. Then I'm gonna go ahead and just go in with the little rosy color and I'm gonna apply it around my cheeks like if it were blush. This is probably the closest thing I'll ever get to blush because I just don't like it, to be honest. So I'm not sure if you're able to see it on camera, but this right here just looks kind of like very pinky. I don't know, like if it were blush. It looks amazing. I love it. And then I'm just gonna go over with my highlight again just to like blend in the two. So then I'm gonna go ahead and go in with my Milani highlighter. I've used this actually in previous videos. I am going to apply this in the inner corner of my eye and then also right under where I applied all of those colors to provide a little more bronzy tone, which is kind of like right here. So now I'm just gonna go ahead and apply color under my lid, which is down here, and I'm gonna go in with that same palette I used, and I'm gonna be using the darkest shade that is in here, which is this one over here, and I'm just gonna apply that all under my eye.
It's taking like forever for me to film this shit.
So now that I've done most of my look, I'm gonna go ahead and do eyelashes. For eyelashes, I'm gonna be using these wispy eyelashes. They are from Ardell. Originally, I paid, as you guys could see, $11.99 for them. It was buy one, get one half off. So I practically got them for super cheap. You guys can find great deals like this. I got this one, this deal at Ulta, so that was amazing. I know that Walmart has wispy eyelashes for about $11 to $12 as well for like a 5-pack. So they're pretty great deals, that way you have eyelashes. So when applying my eyelashes, what I like to do is curl them first. And then for the second step, I'm gonna go ahead and go in and apply mascara. And then I'm gonna put the eyelashes on. If you guys noticed a difference in my video clip, like it looked one color, I feel like it looked warmer before than it does now. It's because I was using my camera before and then that thing just kept turning off. I don't know, my camera's been fucking frustrating me. So then I'm using my cell phone right now. So I feel like the lighting, or it just picks up the colors a lot different. Okay, so I let that first layer of glue kind of dry. So then I'm gonna go back in with glue again and I'm gonna apply a second layer. And it's just gonna be a super thin layer. Don't get all crazy, okay? Don't get all crazy. Don't get crazy on me. Okay, so I'm gonna go ahead and just go in with my NYX Cosmetics MAC lip liner. And this one's in the shade Mason. And I'm just gonna outline my lips. Now, I wanna go ahead and try this lipstick that this little palette came with. It looks kinda nudey, but it is a matte finish, and I do not like matte finish. So I'm gonna use a lip shimmer, which is kinda like lip gloss. And this one is from NYX Lingerie Collection, and this one's in the shade Butter. So I'm just gonna apply this one. I actually really like this combo. I'm living. Alright guys, so that is all for today's video. I hope you guys enjoyed it. Do not forget to give this video a thumbs up and subscribe if you guys have not done so yet. I'm gonna go ahead and leave a link to all the products that I used in the description box. But yeah, that'll be all for today. So I'll see you guys next time.